You looking for a place to talk about OTC and penny stocks? Follow me.
You found it. This is On Top and Hot. I'm John Zidar, and this is Tuesday, March 7th. We do like to talk about OTC and penny stocks in this show. As a matter of fact, that's all we do. But every day we're talking about different stocks. Which ones? The ones that have the potential to make us money. We're not just sitting around here gabbing about the stocks everybody else is gabbing about. The ones that were flying high today, taking gains. Why? They've already given away most of what they're going to give. We want to find stocks that haven't yet run. So a lot of the stocks we're looking at are under the radar. But I'm doing my due diligence primarily by looking at the charts first. I'm looking for strong chart setup. Now, I'm not going to ignore news, but I want the charts to be right, even if it's got great news. So those are the sort of stocks we're going to look at. The other thing they all have in common, they're all under $5. They're penny stocks. That's what a penny stock is. Nothing more, nothing less. Any stock under $5. And they're on every single market, the OTC, the major exchanges. And we're going to look at them wherever they are. Now, when I do my research on these stocks, and I mean all of them, major exchange, OTC, I initially start here, the OTCmarkets.com website. Now, it is particularly for the OTC market, but they bring in a lot of information about the major exchange stocks, so it is not going to hurt you to start here. And why would you start here? Because it's updated every single day by FINRA and the SEC. Think about that. No sorting through old information like you do on Google every single time. This is all current information. And if per chance you don't find what you're looking for, the internet's always out there waiting for you. So how did our market finish today? Well, let's see what we got here. We haven't refreshed this. I'm hoping for something more than that. Well, a little bit more, but nothing to get excited about, except I do see we are over 250,000 trades. Our average for a very long time was between 250,000 and 300,000 trades. And then for virtually all of February, we were under 250,000, hovering near 200,000. That was scary. We didn't want to get any lower than this, and we were there. So I'm glad to see us at least back up to 253,000 trades today. Share volume is still very low. We really do need to be at 10 billion. That is getting out of bed. You're starting to actually move, hitting second gear. We can't get over 5 billion and stay there. Dollar volume, preferably, we'd like to be at 2 billion. Now, it's not like strong dollar volume is going to help the market move, but common sense says the more money that's in the market, the better it is for all of us, because that's what we're there for, to take some money out of it. So the more they put in, the more we can take. Right now, they're not putting in a whole lot of money. I've got some interesting stocks to show you today. You know, every day I go out there hunting for stocks to share with you. And a lot of times it feels like I'm cutting a path through the jungle. Really. And other days it's feng shui. It's this very fluidic current. And that's the way it was today. I've got three stocks that are all from different sectors, but they all just kind of segue one into the other. All right. Now that I've got you confused, let me show you what I got. This first stock we're taking a look at, it's caught my interest in a lot of different ways, and I think it has a lot of potential. Now, this stock, I've got to admit, probably found me, and I didn't find it. This is ticker DPUI, Discount Print USA. Now, you know where I get my stocks from that we talk about. I go out looking for them and finding them by looking at the news, studying the charts. That's not how I found DPUI. I was just trading, doing my normal thing, had a scanner open, but paying attention to what was happening around me. And boom, she introduced herself, jumped up at the top of my scanner with this huge amount of volume, so much so that I wanted to know why. So I came running on over here, and wham, there was this huge piece of news that's going to change everything for this company. And the other thing was, it was the first piece of news they had had in over 8 months. And you can tell, the investors got quite excited. And then I looked over at the filings. There's even a couple good finds over there as well. So I think this is a good stock to consider right now, especially considering the price. She finished the day at under a half a penny, 0.0046, with just a little over 2% gains. Folks, I see so much potential in this company, what's going to happen right now, that this price is just luscious. It is juicy and dripping. She is on the pink tier. She's current. She's got a transfer agent verified, but we don't have that other green tick I'm always telling you to look for, verified profile. I would like to see that. So what does this company do? Well, they tell us here that Discount Print is a commercial print brokerage firm that offers low-priced, high-quality printing services to individuals and businesses alike online. That's where their business is. They're not a company around in all these buildings. They're online, and they offer all these different types of print services to basically anybody. So what was the relative volume today? Yeah, lots of excitement. I told you there was a huge increase in volume. It was pouring in. She jumped from 289,000 shares a day to over 20 million today. I don't know how much that is. 10? I don't know. It's a lot, folks. It's a huge increase. Share structure for the company. Outstanding shares. They got 45 million. I went to see if this was right. It is. We've actually got good math here this time. So our float is pretty decent. We've got an 18 million float. Financials for the company. Looking at our annuals. 2022, we got $304,000, not $304. There are three zeros here. We got to put those behind any of the numbers on these charts. Looking at the quarterly, well, we got four quarters here for 2022. We got them all. Add all that up, you're at roughly $350,000. So they are climbing from 304 to 350. It's not fast, it's not big, but it is steady growth. But the news that came out today is going to change everything. And I think the financials are the big thing that's going to change here. Looking at her disclosures. Well, there are a couple disclosures here I want to point out. Most of them we don't have to really much concern ourselves with. But we've got two 13Gs here. A 13G is a filing for beneficiary ownership. Or in other words, you've taken on a new partner. This is somebody that invests enough money in the company that they get a portion of the company, a certain percentage. And Quick Capital is the person that invested both times. Between the two, they're just a little over 10% of the company. So here in the last 60 days, you've had someone buy 1/10 of the company and they now own it. They have voting rights to that. And they also see value. You don't go investing that sort of money unless you believe in the company. Let's take a look at that news now. So as I said, the company hasn't had any news for 8 months. Their last piece of news came out in June of last year when they had a public offering. Then they had a piece of news that came out today. They tell us here that Discount Print USA announces initial entry into a $50 billion U.S. convention industry market. The company's new division that they just started is called Convention Printing of America. They have opened 11 new local offices in key U.S. cities in the last 5 months. This is the change. It's retroactive. While everybody else is closing their doors, shutting down their stores, getting rid of the rents and the leases and the property taxes and going digital, this company's coming out of the digital world back into brick and mortar. And they are getting offices in all sorts of places. Initially, they have 11 out in the first 5 months. They tell us that they have an aggressive plan to open 39 more regional U.S. offices in the next 24 months. That's going to give them 50 offices. Basically one for each state. Now, whether that's how they set it up or not, I don't know. But you can see down here a map of where their first 11 are. And they are putting these in high commercial, high industrial areas where they're going to get a lot of business. Now, think about this. When you're online, as a printer, you have got hundreds, probably thousands of competitors that you have to deal with. And the only thing that differentiates you from them is where you're listed in Google, pretty much. Where here, you're gonna get that local business from all of the people around you, and you're gonna have a few competitors in the city, just a few, and you know you're gonna lock in a certain amount of that business. And it's probably even gonna be more convenient for the customers. Local, You know, they come in, actually bring you their file or their form, put it in your hands instead of trying to figure out a way to upload it. Come by and pick it up. Don't have to wait for it to be mailed. Hope it didn't get lost or beat up on the way. So I think this is going to be big business. Even though people don't read magazines and newspapers much anymore, we still print up flyers, brochures, calendars of our ex-lovers or our pets. We do that. And there's lots of business out there. And I think their stores going back to brick and mortar is going to do them a heck of a lot more business than what they're doing online. And I think the excitement that we've seen today that you're going to see on the charts is just the beginning of where we're going to see this chart go. You want to see this chart? Come on, I'll show it to you. We're going to be doing all the charting on these stocks on my free trading platform, Think or Swim. You get this free just by signing up for the free trading account with TD Ameritrade. So we are looking at DPUI. This is a 1 year, 1 day chart. We got a high bubble a year ago, an impressive high of 35 cents. Then we hit a low in February of under a half a penny, 0045. And currently we're at 0046. And look at our volume today, folks. That is just today's volume. That is incredible. Looking at the volume over the past year, there is nothing to compare. We can't say she's under the radar anymore. Looking at our 6 month, 4 hour view, we have dropped from that 35 cent high down to 7.5 cents now over the last 6 months. And she has gone flat. She's been underneath the 50 for a very long time and isn't going hardly anywhere. She keeps banging her head, getting just above it, but not really succeeding. Today, she did the same thing. We had another breakout. She did get up over the 50 and she has fallen right back underneath where she's very comfortable. Except we got two things going on here. One, we got a ton of volume that came in today. No duh. But then look at our 200. It was very steep up here. There was no way this was going to try to jump up to the 200 here. But once this comes down and gets close and level, once it starts to plane out, that becomes the most advantageous time for the price to jump. So we could see something. Now looking at our technicals, I really can't see that PPO. This is way flat. All right, she is drooping. The PPO is like the MACD. They both have that blue line that you want on top of the other line, and you want them rising. The MACD works with the whole price. The PPO works with the percentage of the price. I prefer the PPO over the MACD, but I do use them both. RSI is falling too. Nothing is falling fast and furious or frantically, but they are still pushing down. 20-day, 1 hour view. So she was under the 50, over the 50, under the 50. I mean, she's just, you know, rambling around here. She came all the way back down to this low here and then jumped from the absolutely low all the way up, hitting a high bubble and tagging that 200-day SMA, which also is now planing out and becoming available to jump on. She has pulled back though, gone to her comfortable zone underneath that 50-day SMA. And on the 1 hour chart, there is nothing to brag about with our technicals. Everything is still drooping and falling right now. 5 day, 5 minute. She is still on a downtrend. She was above her 9 day up here at this high. She's gotten underneath her 9 day SMA, which is the fall mode. She cannot climb until she's on top of the nine. She's underneath her 50, underneath her nine. We got our ADX. This is my trend continuation. This straight line tells me that whatever trend is happening on the chart is going to continue. It's not about whether this is pointing up or down, just this line. So if that line doesn't change direction, it means this is still falling. So I would wait. I would watch this ADX as it keeps climbing and going straight. This price is going to keep coming further and further down. And when you see this blue line and red line start to separate and get further apart, that's when she's going to rise. I personally would pick up a entry right there. Not everything, because it could be up until the next financial. We don't know. Now, I think she could start to move. We've seen a lot of volume. There could be a lot more excitement coming. People could be thinking just the way I am. or we could have to wait to the next financials or the next news press. In either case, I think it's going to grow. I think this is a great price. You get 25% of what you want right now. She falls, you can get yourself some more. She rises, grab what you can before she starts to storm away. I like DPUI for a swing play. We're not talking about a day trade, but for a swing. Do your own due diligence, though. You may find more information that's even more exciting than what I shared with you. Maybe. This next stock we're taking a look at is a perfect one to follow the first one. See, that first company, they were printing primarily on paper. This company is printing on aluminum cans. This is Wild Pack Beverage, ticker WLDPF. Now, I found this one, like we find most of our stocks nowadays, by looking at the charts. And she has got a lovely chart. She hasn't got any filings, and to be quite honest, she hasn't got any lingering news. But what she does have is a lot of hot, current news. So WLDPF finished today just under 14 cents and just under 5% gains. She's on the pink tier. She's current. Got those two green ticks I'm always telling you to look for. And she's got independent directors. This is good. See, independent directors are primarily only needed whenever you're going to uplist. And considering they're on the pink, they got nowhere to go but up. And you really don't need independent directors for anything else. So it looks like they have intentions. So what does Wild Pack Beverage do? Well, they package beverages. They don't just print the cans, they do everything. Say a lemonade company wants to use them. They take the lemonade, put it in the can, print the can or print a sleeve and shrink wrap it to the can. They package it, they put it in trucks, and they distribute it. They take care of all of that for their customers. So what was the relative volume around the company today? Let's see what we got. What? Oh my God. That's not under the radar, that's ignored. I mean, even stocks that are going bankrupt or being kicked off the major exchanges never do that. I don't know what to think, except, ooh, buying opportunity, wow. Dropped from 14,000 shares a day, which is already under the radar, to 675 shares today. Ooh, share structure for this company, God. Outstanding shares, we've got 111 million. Float, they say it's 46 million here, but that was 8 months ago. So I did jump into Google. What does Google tell us? Well, looking here, they say we've got a float of 54 million, 51 million, and it looks like that's it. So it looks like we are at about 50 million roughly, which isn't a bad float. You know, we can live with that. It's better than 500 million or a billion. Financials for WLDPF. Now, it really is all about the financials with this company. We've got 1 year of revenues here, 2021. They did $28 million. Now, you can think of that as roughly $7 million a quarter. Now, when you look at their 2022 quarters, you see an improvement. They've jumped to 8.5 million, virtually 9 million, 8.1 million. So they are increasing revenues quarter to quarter. But that's just part of the story. There's a lot more to tell, and it's all in the news. And since we have no disclosures to look at, let's just go directly on over to that news. So we got lots of news here about the company. Everything that's not highlighted, it's primarily about their financials and the progress that they're making. And we are going to look at that. But before we do, I want to cover the three deals they have made since October. This deal here in October, they did a partnership with EHP Labs. They got a 2-year contract with this company to create their flagship product, OxyShred, for U.S. distribution. They are going to be packaging 30 million cans in 2023 and 40 million cans in 2024. Now, the CEO of EHP Labs, he just invested $1 million into this company. So he just doesn't use their services. He believes enough in them to invest in them. And more to the point, this company just appointed him as one of the board of directors of the company. So there's definitely a partnership going on there. Then we've got another piece of news on the right page that came out in November. Wild Pack and Woodstream announced sustainability partnership. This was a great deal they made here. Actually, it was a decision. They quit doing plastic. That's what they were working with. They were printing plastic, making sleeves for plastic. They got away from it totally for all the right reasons. Everybody is happy. It was a prudent decision. And the last deal that came in January, it was an in-house deal. It was one of their subsidiaries. They thought it would be better to have the subsidiary as part of them rather than separate. So they brought them in with them. And then we've got the rest of the news. So let's take a look at that right now. This is going to cover November, December, January, February. Every single month, they're telling us their revenues. God, I wish every company would do this. So real briefly, November's revenues confirmed $5.8 million with 184 orders. Now remember, they were getting $7 million, $8 million a quarter. What's that coming down to? About $2.7 million a month? Well, right here, they did 5.8. That is double. Then we look at December's. They did $5.6 million in December with 224 orders. January, $5.2 million. And March, whoa, look at the jump. $7.2 million in 1 month. The last 3 months, they did five, seven. You're looking at $17, $18 million they did in one quarter, when their strongest quarter was $8 million that we were looking at. So the money is pouring in, and they've got an annualized run rate here. What they're basically telling us is the projection. They think they're going to be doing about $86 million at the end of the year. That is an incredible growth. But you can see that going from quarter to quarter, and now looking at these news presses going month to month. So everything looks good here. And as I said, she's got a lovely chart. Let me share that with you. Ooh, this is a lovely chart. This is Wildpack, ticker WLDPF. We got a 6 month, 4 hour view here. Our high bubble is in August at 23.5 cents. Our low bubble at the end of December, almost 6 cents. She was on a downtrend from this high bubble all the way down to that low bubble and then changed. We are now on an uptrend. It started off very slowly, just sneaking over that 20-day SMA, jumping on top of the 50, and then hurriedly getting onto her 9-day escalator and climbing towards that 200-day SMA. Volume was nil today, but you can see it's hot and cold through this period. What is tremendously hot? All of our technicals. Every single oscillator here is pushing up and on fire. Even our RSI is up at 75 right now. You cannot lose if all of your oscillators are pointing up. 20-day, 1 hour view. Got a low bubble here of 7.7 cents. High bubble today, 13.8 cents. She was on top of her 9 when she jumped here and never came underneath her 9 again. Even when she dipped and had these red bars, she was still floating like helium on top of her 9-day SMA. Speaking of SMAs, all of these are very nicely placed. That's beautiful. Looks like a brilliant broom. That's what you want to see. And all of our technicals are still perfect. Every single one is climbing, and our RSI is still on fire at 72. 5 day, 5 minute, no complaints here. She was on top of the 9, did have a little dip here and broke it, but with some fervor, she jumped real hard, got back up here and fell right back into line, and looks like she's ready to continue. And all of our technicals say the same thing. She is looking strong, like she still wants to grow. The money is increasing at such a rate right now, folks. I mean, they're going to be doing 100, 200% of their revenues. So I think there's a lot more going to come here. We just seen some of the volume come in. I would keep my eye on WLDPF. No bout a doubt it. This last ticker we're taking a look at fits in beautifully with the three we've considered. First one was printing on paper. Second company was a beverage company printing on the cans. And this is a beverage company. This is Splash Beverage Group, ticker SBEV. Found this one because the chart looks good. It's in a strong continuation pattern. Came over here, we got a couple filings we can look at, but they've got a lot of big news. Not only are their revenues growing, but they are expanding their footprint in a very big way. So SBEV, she finished the day at $1.45 and just a little over 2% gains. This is a penny stock on the New York Stock Exchange. So what exactly does Splash Beverage do? Well, they make and sell their own line of beverages. Splash Beverage Group specializes in manufacturing, distribution, and sales and marketing of various beverages across multiple channels. SBG believes its business model is unique as it only develops and/or accelerates brands it perceives to have highly visible pre-existing brand awareness or pure category innovation. Right now, they've basically got four different beverages. They've got their sangria that is in a can. They've got their vino wines. This comes in a glass, a jar, whichever you want to think of it as. They also have various flavors of tequila. And then they have a sports performance drink called Tap Out. These are their beverages that they are moving around the country right now. So what was the relative volume around the company today? About even. She's normally doing 172,000 shares. Today she did 178,000 shares. Just even keel. Looking at our share structure, we've got 40,000 outstanding, so I'm expecting the float not to be bad. They tell us here that the float, well, that was back in 2021, so who cares what they told us. Looking over here at Google, I did a search. I come up with three numbers, 27 million, 30 million, and 30 million. So roughly, we have a float of about 30 million. We can live with that. Financials for SBEV. Well, we had a huge jump here. 2019, $20,000. 2020, $2.3 million. 2021, $11.3 million. The revenues are picking up very quickly. Then when you look at 2022, 3.9, 4.4, 4.8. What do you got there? Roughly 5, 10, 13, 14. $14 million in three quarters when they had $11 million in four quarters last year. So they are picking up momentum. They are kicking butt. Looking at her disclosures, well, we've got a little bit to consider over here. We've got some 8Ks, and I always like to look at 8Ks because they're material change, things that are happening that are important, but they're not always acquisitions or mergers. This 8K here, this was a shareholders vote. This 8K was the amendment that they voted on. And this 8K, it's pretty good. We had an investor come into the company, buy a whole bunch of shares, $4 million investment. And that pretty much takes care of our filings. Looking at the news. Now, the company has a lot of news. It's just not all current. All this news up here, it's years old. This is from 2019, back when they did the reverse merger so that Splash Beverage could get on the market, all the way up to 2021. But down here, we've got lots of current news, and it's all about expansion, getting more distributors, expanding their business across the country. Now, most of this, actually all of this, is about the East Coast. Going back to December, Splash Beverage Group adds 9 distributors to cover latest tap-out retail authorizations in southeastern U.S. This is from Florida to Virginia. Another one, Splash Beverage Group's tap-out received authorization from premier supermarket chain Publix across 5 southeastern states. Then here in February, the company adds Florida's J.J. Taylor Distributing Company to assist with the tap-out performance drink distribution. Also in February, the company reached an agreement with 3 distributors bringing the salt tequila to significant portions of New York. And finally, 5 days ago, the company reaches distribution agreement with Carolina Premium Beverage for North Carolina. You can see how the East Coast is just being swamped. North Carolina, Florida to Virginia, New York. But they're not just on the East Coast. We got an update letter here that came out on January 5th, and they give us some insight. They've got deals with lots of companies, Circle K, Publix, Target, 7-Eleven, AMPM, which is a BP petroleum company, Winn-Dixie Supermarkets. But notice what they say over here, for the West Coast of the U.S., in the West Coast stores. So they're on the West Coast, they're on the East Coast, no wonder they're doing so well. In addition, Salt Tequila continues its expansion with distribution agreements in Nevada and Maryland. All told, we added more than a dozen and a half new distributors and a half a dozen national and regional retail chain authorizations, adding thousands of new shelves to fill as we prepare for 2023. Setting up this many distributors and chains is an arduous process and takes time. However, we believe we are poised to realize the impact of these additional accounts beginning in early 2023 and are very pleased with our progress as we continue to build distribution throughout the U.S. All this added business needed additional hands to manage the growth, so we brought on industrial veteran James Allred, recently of Anheuser-Busch InBev, to lead the sales team. We have also brought on a celebrity for support. NFL great Drew Brees is now an ambassador for Tap Out. So they got a lot of things going on. They've got people coming in. They are spreading around on the East Coast and the West Coast. Their revenues are growing at an extremely strong rate. I don't see any reason not to consider this stock. And when you look at the charts, it's just one more reason to think about it. So we're going to take a look at ticker SBEV. This is Splash Beverage Group. As you can see, I've got some support and resistance lines here. I did not draw them today. So let's go back a year and see when I did draw them. Further back than a year, I'm going to have to go back 3 years, 1 week. There it is. All right, so we looked at this on January of last year, over a year ago. And these support resistances that I drew back then and stuck are being used right now. Now, since we're here, you can see we had a high back in September of 2020 of $15.30. Woo-woo! Coming back down to that six-month, four-hour view. Our high here in July was $3.45. She fell from that high, breaking her 200, fell even faster, and she has come all the way down here to 75 cents halfway through January. Once she hit this low bubble, she changed her trend, right? She is now on an uptrend. She got up over top of that 50 in a big hurry, pushed herself to the 200 without any delay, just jumped on over it, took a bounce right here, and launched herself. Got on top of this support. That's the only thing above this 200-day SMA, but she's under the 50. Rolled that support right there and then took off here. Got on top of her 9 and has been climbing hard. Actually broke the next support up. We've got a third one above that. This one here is at $1.52. We're at $1.45. This one is at $2. As you can see, she came off the bottom, hit the top, fell, is now rolling off of her 50-day SMA and is pushing back up. I fully expect her to get on top of this support and then start climbing to that $2 mark. Our volume, pretty steady through here. Doesn't look super strong today, a little less actually, and she's still growing with less volume. Our technicals, we got a nice bounce on our PPO right there. Boink, and going up. Same with our MACD, she bounced off the signal line, had a crossover, and look at all those green bars accumulating right now. And our MACD has been pushing up and is currently at 58. Looking at that 20-day, one-hour view. All right, squeeze this down so we can see all of our supports. She was suckled right to this support right here until she got close enough to that 200-day SMA. Right there, and she jumped. She jumped on top of her 9-day SMA, had a pullback to her 20, not the 50, just the 20, pushed up here to that high, over this support resistance, came back down. She's trying to respect the 50 here as best she can, got close to the 200, and then got back on her 50, and is on top of her 9. Has had a little bit of pullback here, but everything is looking pretty decent. Technicals, they were strong, but that little bit of pullback right there is showing up as pullback on our oscillators as well. 5-day, 5-minute chart. So she was under the 200 here after she hit a high. She came down underneath her 50, fell way low. Then she broke her 50, hung to the 50, got over the 200. You can see our bars are getting bigger here. She is bouncing around a lot. She's on her 20, she's on her 50, but she's not coming under the 50 until right there. So we got to keep our eye on her right here. Technicals, yeah, everything is like a coin in the air right now. But I like SBEV. They are getting their business from one side of the country to the other side of the country. You can see their revenues are growing. They're getting lots of distributors. They've got some products that cover different areas. They've got, you know, sports drinks. They've got alcoholic drinks. They've got casual drinks like wine and sangria. So they've got the bases covered. SBEV, I looked at it a year ago. Looks like I liked her then. I like her again. So did you see that feng shui we had going on there? We had a company printing on paper, slid over to a beverage company that printed on cans, and then slid over to a beverage company. I love it. But what I really like is the other thing they all have in common. They're all about ready to explode with their revenues, whether it be new distribution deals or building out or contracts. All of them are ready to explode. We see the signs and the charts are warm too. So I'm expecting some money here, folks. But of course, do your own due diligence. Don't just count on me. I only give some of it to you. There's always more to know. Remember, folks, the more you know, the more you're gonna grow. See ya.